Hi guys, today I want to continue to discuss UFOs, which are no longer a fringe conspiracy, but a serious topic of conversation. Not long ago, the US Congress implied that UFOs have non-human origins. The Pentagon released a group of footages from the US Navy, renamed their long-running UFO office, and expanded their research mission. The revised definition of UFO also includes transmedium objects. Transmedium means UFOs have the ability to traverse space, air, or ocean seamlessly. These flying objects of unknown origin are demonstrating extraordinarily advanced technology beyond our comprehension. If we can grasp and duplicate any of the UFO's fascinating technologies, it will be revolutionary. In order to do so, I think it will be helpful to study the unique UFO features many people have observed and reported. This baffling phenomenon can help us to understand, at least partially, how these highly advanced crafts function and what kind of technology might be utilized. I'll talk about four unique features in this video. If we can find a single answer or solution to explain all these characteristics, then that solution probably relates to the secret behind UFO's otherworldly movements. Let's dive in. The first unique feature is what I just mentioned, that UFOs are transmedium vehicles. They were seen to plunge into and come out of the ocean. It's as if UFOs have the combined abilities of a rocket, helicopter, airplane, and a submarine. This is impossible with our current level of technology. So much so that a national security-focused report states that transmedium threats to United States national security are expanding exponentially. The second feature is that these fast-moving UFOs are extremely quiet. They don't even cause sonic booms when they're going supersonic. However, conventional aircrafts such as helicopters, airplanes, and fighter jets are all very loud. People on the ground can hear aircraft noises when they fly close enough. In comparison, UFOs are described by eyewitnesses to be shockingly quiet despite their high speeds. They can hover silently in the air while our helicopters are deafening loud. Looking at the footage of a helicopter, we can almost feel the significant wind and airflow it generates. That leads to the third unique feature about UFOs, that they seem to be flying effortlessly with not much airflow and drag. Air drag is sometimes called air resistance or fluid friction. It's caused by the interaction and contact of a solid body with a fluid, liquid or gas. An example would be the drag force resists a skydiver's downward movement caused by gravity. The fourth feature is the strange, fuzzy, and indefinite illumination, the colorful glow encircling the entire UFOs when observed at night. Some say the glowing lights were spinning or flickering with colors like red, orange, or blue. These mysterious glows covering UFOs are distinct from our conventional crafts. These four unique features separate UFOs from our airplanes, which indicates the two function fundamentally different. Our aircrafts fly with the help of moving parts, such as propellers and turbine blades that produce persistent noise and strong airflow. While the UFOs can travel into the ocean, make no noise, present no obvious airflow or drag, and they have interesting colorful glows. I won't get into the various shapes of UFOs because I think just like our aircrafts, the shapes of alien flying machines likely relates to their energy creation, conversion, and distribution to maximize the craft's overall efficiency. Now, moving forward, what can we learn from these four features? What kind of propulsion system can fulfill or result in these characteristics? In my last two videos, I presented my hypothesis that a flying saucer documented by Bob Lazar was not powered by anti-gravity, but electromagnetic forces. Electromagnetism is a much stronger force than gravity, a staggering 10 to the power 40 times stronger. I proposed that a saucer was equipped with an onboard compact nuclear fusion reactor. The energy generated from the reactor creates ionized air or ion wind as propulsion, with the three emitters down below. The UFO works similar to an iron-propelled craft and employs electrohydrodynamics, EHD concept. EHD ion craft is known to be energy efficient, quiet, generates no heat, has no moving parts, and emits visible coronal discharge. Assuming the flying saucer was really propelled by EHD drive in the air, can it also work underwater or in space? Potentially, yes, at least in theory. Scientists have confirmed that electricity and magnetism are essentially two aspects of the same thing. A changing electric field creates a magnetic field, and a changing magnetic field creates an electric field. In electromagnetism studies, the interactions of electromagnetic fields and the electrically conducting fluids have attracted increasing attention due to applications in diverse areas. The subject has classically been divided into two separate, simplified categories: electrohydrodynamics, EHD, and magnetohydrodynamics, MHD. This division was necessary to reduce the extreme complexity of the coupled system and constitutive equations describing combined electromagnetohydrodynamics. Though we should know that EHD and MHD are not really separable. They represent different perspectives of the same system, and they always work jointly, a bit like viewing a house from different angles. Let's get back to the peculiar transmedium feature of UFOs. EHD drive can create ionized air as a propulsion force in the atmosphere. What about the MHD aspect? It turns out that MHD has been considered as the main propulsion system for both marine and spaceships. Prototypes of MHD ships have been developed in the US and Japan. MHD flights have been explored too. Same with the EHD ironcraft and thrusters, a MHD drive has no moving parts, which means it will be silent, reliable, and efficient. Another interesting thing is, an MHD converter is a reversible device, so the same machine can act either as an electrical generator or a fluid accelerator to create propulsion. Think of its role where it can switch between a generator and a propeller. So, EHD propulsion operates in the atmosphere, and MHD works in both marine and spaceships. To me, this means a combined EHD-MHD, a unified electromagneto-hydrodynamic drive, might work as a well-rounded propulsion system for transmedium crafts. Therefore, the first unique feature of UFOs could be possibly answered by electromagnetic propulsion. Such a device propels vehicles using only electrical and magnetic fields to accelerate a conductive propellant liquid, such as ionized air or salt water. It can work in the atmosphere, the ocean, and in space. When the working fluid is ionized to become electrically conductive, that is known as plasma. In physics, plasma is the fourth state of matter, an electrical conducting medium which contains a considerable portion of charged particles, ions, and electrons. Plasma is usually associated with very high temperatures, though there are also non-thermal plasmas, known as cold plasmas, which are partially ionized gases. Cold plasma can be close to room temperature, and you can touch it with your hand. A declassified document written in 2010 shows the U.S. Defense Intelligence Agency did an in-depth review on a novel propulsion concept utilizing plasma, ionized gases, and magnetohydrodynamics, MHD. This report affirms that MHD concepts are shown to be attractive due to their potential to achieve propulsion and aerodynamic performance far beyond current conventional technologies. However, significant difficulties impact the development and application of these technologies. The first topic discussed in this report is weakly ionized plasmas, aka cold plasmas, for propulsion applications. The link to this paper is in the video's description section if you want to read it. It appears that plasma could be a crucial part of the transmedium possible, a combined EHD-MHD propulsion system. And not coincidentally, plasma is also the key to unravel the other three unique features of UFOs, which are, let me recite them, UFOs fly super quietly with no sonic boom, no obvious airflow or drag, and the crafts have an overall glow or luminance. Now let's see what role plasma plays in these features. Our current airplanes are really loud. A moving aircraft causes friction and turbulence, which triggers sound waves and air drag. Generally, the faster the aircraft is flying, the more turbulence, friction, and drag will occur, and the louder it might be. A sonic boom is the noise created by the shock waves formed when a flying object travels faster than the speed of sound. Shockwave is a detriment in the development of supersonic aircrafts. It increases flow drag as well as surface heating from additional friction. It also initiates sonic boom on the ground. Please note that sonic booms are not just a noise. They can be powerful enough to rattle buildings and break windows. Since they are rather damaging to humans, animals, and buildings, supersonic commercial flights were banned to fly overland in 1973. UFOs, on the other hand, are described to be silent, even when they went hypersonic, and seem to generate no shockwaves or drag. How did they do that? Besides their aerodynamic shapes, here is where plasma comes into play. Multiple studies have proven that simple plasma actuators could dramatically mediate drag and shockwaves, enhance airflow control, increase fuel efficiency, and improve performance of supersonic aircrafts. A plasma actuator is lightweight and low cost, generally only contains two electrically charged copper plates to transform surrounding air to plasma and alter airflows. With the help of plasma, there will be much less drag and no sonic boom. Hence, supersonic airliners might become economically viable. This will allow passengers to travel great distances in very short times. For instance, from New York to Sydney, Australia, in less than 3 hours. Moreover, plasma can also influence airflow at subsonic speeds that even on-ground trucks can benefit from. The plasma actuators on trucks can counter drag, turbulence, and save a lot of fuel. A side outcome is that the plasma actuator might give the truck a pretty purple glow. As we know, plasma is luminous. This luminosity is produced when the electrons gain sufficient energy to generate visible light by excitation collisions which emit photons. Here is footage of plasma confinement on a disc-shaped electrode. We can see it creates a glow very similar to the fuzzy sheath of illumination surrounding UFOs. Plus, the plasma glow also spins and shifts pretty much like the UFOs. It's conceivable that a UFO's intense propulsion can generate a strong field force, powerful enough to make its inductive shell excite and ionize air molecules around it. Or maybe the UFO exterior contains electrodes to ionize the surrounding air into plasma. Assuming the UFO lights indeed come from energized or ionized air, then why are they in different colors? Red, orange, and blue. Of all the visible colors, red and orange correspond to the least energy. They are also the most common colors associated with UFO low-power operations, such as hovering or slower maneuvers. Blue light, on the contrary, has the highest energy and the shortest wavelength on the spectrum of visible light. Our atmosphere is mainly made of 78% nitrogen and 21% oxygen. They will be the dominant air molecules interacting with the UFO's energy force. When the air absorbs a certain level of energy, it makes an atom move from a ground state to an excited state. More energy is required to ionize the atom. Excited nitrogen has a red color, and excited oxygen can range from red to yellow. Ionized nitrogen yields a higher energy with a blue color, and oxygen plasma emits a pale blue light. So the different colors around UFOs might correlate with the energy level exerted by the UFO propulsion. These glowy lights are not mere byproducts of the power radiation, but an intended design. As I mentioned earlier, the plasma outlayer would remarkably increase UFO's flying efficiency because it reduces or eliminates air drag, saves fuel, and improves flow control. the plasma sheath actually makes a substantial contribution to the UFO's highly advanced maneuvers. Okay, so the four unique features of UFOs, which are transmedium travel ability, no sonic boom, no air drag, and an encircling colorful glow, likely are all tied to one single answer, plasma. As a result, I propose the following possibility. High-performing UFOs are propelled by electromagnetic forces in the means of unified electromagnetofluid dynamic drive. The initial power was created using an onboard source of energy, a nuclear reactor which doubles as an atomic battery. The reactor generates strong energy to ionize fluids and create plasma. When the plasma passes through a curated electromagnetic field, it produces a Lorentz force to propel the craft. The powerful electric current from the reactor also induces an overall plasma layer outside the craft to streamline the flying experience. Furthermore, since the conducting medium, plasma, can alter airflow, I wonder if it has a matching effect with liquid water and other kinds of fluids. If so, then plasma might be able to enhance speed and efficiency of ships and submarines as well. At the end, I want to point out that this hypothesis is not that far-fetched or unreachable. In fact, in March 2022, about 7 months ago, NASA published a report confirming the potential of EHD-MHD propulsion and reveals new nuclear power cell that's up to 100 times smaller with more power and as small as a button. If you want to have a read, the link is below. In addition, cold plasmas have drawn a great deal of interest in recent years and are being used in a wide range of new applications in aeronautics. I'm eager to see what these fields will bring us in the near future, especially the prospect of a combined EHD-MHD propulsion, which allows transmedium travel through air, ocean, and space. That'll be quite exciting and momentous. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and share with others. You can also support me on Patreon, which is a monthly charge, kind of like you buying me a cup of coffee once a month. I appreciate your support. This is Curious Being, I'm Tina. Thanks for watching and see you next time.